So which is the best mini tripod for your camera setup? In today's video, we're gonna find out, and we're also comparing the new PodZillas from JOBY and see how they compare to the old GorillaPods. Let's get into it. So why is PodZilla here? Well, I think it's to fix that whole issue that we had with the ball joints. After a while, they kind of get loosened up, and you can even see it right here. Some of that friction is lost. Well, then accidents start happening.
Please, no, no!
And that's no good. So the PodZilla has that metal rod here in the legs, and it's flexible so you can still wrap around things. It's super cool. It's pretty strong, especially when you couple them together. They get a little bit weaker with the smaller guy, but as you'll soon see for the smartphones, this should be more than enough. Now, I bought all of these on my own. These were not sent to me, so this is my honest review. I like the PodZilla grip. It feels a lot more comfortable in hand than these ball joints. Now, there's rubber grips on these, but this has that rubber coating and that same ball feet design. On the PodZilla Medium, it has this really clever push button release system for the ball head, and then as soon as you release it, it kind of locks into place. I found that was pretty clever for those quick reframe, lock it in, and you're good to go. For the PodZilla Large, it comes with the ball joint release. Pretty good. You can ratchet it down pretty tight, and it's locked in there. I know my buddy just kind of leaves it half loose, and then he can kind of friction move it around, quick adjust like the small guy, and that works. Now, the one big negative of this thing to note is this quick release plate. There is no safety release. Now, I like the bubble level, but this kind of cheap chintzy plate that's made out of plastic, and I won't name names, but I had a friend who had a pretty fancy camera on here, accidentally hit the button, and the whole thing slid out, broke a lens, not good. So that reason alone, I think if you have a medium to large size mirrorless or DSLR camera, you're probably gonna need to stick with the medium 3K or the large 5K. The Pro heads are really nice for that quick release system. I'll show you that in a second. But as for this head, it's good for smartphones and stuff, but be careful of that quick release. Now, funny enough, if any of you guys were like me and bought this cheapy guy years ago on Amazon for, I don't know, it's like $5 or something, even these safety screw systems, that way you got that same plate, you can release it, and if you don't want it to accidentally release, you just lock it down and it's tightened. Why JOBY didn't give us some sort of safety release system, I'm not sure, kind of a bummer. Oh, and you'll want to stay till the end where I show you my favorite mini tripod that has multi-use. For both the PodZillas, the medium and the large, they come with the 1/4-20 mount on top, which is nice and universal. I like that. With the 3K Pro and the 5K, you've got the Arca Swiss mount, which I think is awesome and even more adaptable. So you can use their plates, which are awesome, 1/4-20, adapt it over to whatever you want. But then you can also use other Arca Swiss mounts and plates and ratchet in super tight. So that's a huge positive to the old GorillaPod system. Now, part of all that is basically these ball heads that they include on these systems are just more robust. They're metal. They just feel sturdy construction. The big 5K has that smooth panning. A lot of great features over there. Again, on these new PodZillas, they seem to kind of cheapen it out, and you're just stuck with this ball head on here that you can't remove, which is kind of a bummer. Now, it does seem that maybe they're using the new PodZillas to replace their older 1Ks and basic 3K with the similar head mounting ball system. Now, only time will tell if the metal flexible rods will last longer than the ball joints, and I can only guess that these should last longer, which is a great thing to have. My honest opinion is that I think I'd rather have these flexible rods. I mean, give us even a bigger, beefier system for the 5K size. That could be pretty cool. It does seem that JOBY is pushing these smartphone mounts on top of the PodZilla lineup, so maybe that kind of makes sense, that these are better aimed for the smartphone shooters, and these are more for the pro mirrorless DSLR mounts. Now, if you're using your smartphone like me to shoot a lot of your content or family videos, I think the PodZilla lineup is actually a really good fit. Now, if you have a bit heavier camera setup, mirrorless, DSLR, something fancy, I would definitely consider the 3K Pro or the 5K. I love that ball head system. It's just more modular with Arca Swiss, a bit beefier. Now for one of my most used mini tripod setups. This thing is from DJI. It's a little steep, but it's extendable selfie stick. You got great tripod leg system, extra stability. It's great for smartphone shooters and Look at this, it has the ball joint built right in the ball mount. That is super helpful. And it is sturdy enough that if you put on a mirrorless or a little pocket shooter, it would do great. So if you're using your smartphone to shoot a lot of photo and video content like I am, you gotta check out these other smartphone camera accessories that I use all the time. Oh, and if you like GoPros, check out this accessories videos as well.